Morning, dear students. Hope you all are good and safe. I welcome you for the academic year 2020-21. I, Usha N., science teacher, will be handling chemistry part for you. Before going deep into the concepts or straight away jumping into the chapters, let us have a quick recap of what you have studied in class 8 and what will you be studying in class 9. So these are chapters which you have studied in class 8. Natural resources, structure of an atom, atoms and molecule, chemical reaction and its types, chemicals in daily life, water, states of matter. In class 9, you will be studying only 4 chapters in chemistry, that is matter in our surrounding. Is matter around us pure? Atoms and molecules, structure of atoms. When you compare the chapters, there's a link. Matter in our surrounding, it deals with all physical properties of matter. Like 3 types of matter, solid, liquid and gas. What is diffusion? What is Brownian motion? Yeah, you could able to recollect? Yeah. So these are the things which you'll be studying again in case of matter in our surrounding. So only the physical properties of matter you'll be studying. The second chapter is matter around us is pure. It deals with all chemical properties of matter. Like what is compound, what is mixture, how to separate a mixture. There are different methods to separate a mixture. So what's the principle behind that? What are the applications behind that? So all this chemical properties we'll be studying in case of second chapter. Coming to the third chapter, atoms and molecules. Atoms and molecules you already studied in 8th standard, where you have studied about relative atomic mass, relative molecular mass, what is atomic mass, what is a mole, what is molecular mass, how to find percentage composition, all this. So here mainly you'll be studying again. So what are atoms, molecules, compound, basic stuff. Apart from that, you also be studying mole concept in detail. So mainly the problem part. So mole concept, it's not we dealing with only the theoretical part. So it mainly deals with problems. So how to solve the problems, how to convert mole to mass, mass to mole. So it's a continuation of 8th standard. The next is structure of atom. This also you have studied in 8th standard, where the cathode ray, anode ray, Rutherford, Dalton's atomic theory. Same stuff you'll be studying in case of structure of atoms. But in depth, apart from that, you'll be having what are isotopes, isobars, isotones, problems based on isotopes. Yeah. So what is valency? What is valence electron? How ions will be formed? How compounds? So how to write a formula of a compound? All this. So it's an interlink between atoms and molecules and structure of atoms. So you'll be studying all the basics. And you'll enjoy the concept, because if you're strong with the basics of elements, atoms, molecules, compound, how ions are formed, how to write a formula, which is already, I have given a hint in class 8. So if you are thorough with that, class 9, you'll enjoy the concept, where you are applying the same things to 9th standard. So your problem is already solved. So simple things which you already know, if you know the basics, so it's much more enough to just build your knowledge. So this will be the class 9 portions. So today you should be knowing the basic concepts in chemistry. So today's session, you have to know these basic concepts in chemistry. The first is, what is an atom? So atom is the smallest fundamental unit of a matter. If I say hydrogen, yes, it's an atom. Element. So what is an element? So element is made from one particular type of an atom. If I say gold, gold, it's an element, right? It is made up of gold atoms only. I cannot see hydrogen atoms, I cannot see oxygen atoms in that, right? So that is element. What is molecule? Molecule, it's a cluster of atoms. So group of atoms. If I take H2, there is 2 atoms of hydrogen. If I take O2, 2 atoms of oxygen. So it's a molecule, it's a cluster of atoms, and they are chemically combined. So there's a bond formation between them. So it's a compound. Compound, it's a substance which is made from more than 2 elements. And they always combine in a fixed ratio by mass. Okay, we won't take the number of atoms usually when we just find out the things, we have to find out their mass. If example like H2O, so H2O, the mass of hydrogen is 1, right? There is 2 hydrogen atoms, you will say it as 2. Oxygen, atomic mass is 16. So 2 is to 16. Go for the simple ratio, it will become 1 is to 8. So 1 part of hydrogen requires 8 parts of oxygen to form water. If I supply 4 parts of oxygen and there's 1 part of hydrogen, you won't get water, you'll get some other compound. So always a fixed ratio has to be there to form any particular compound to exist in nature, and they are chemically combined. Means bond formation will be there. Okay. Next, what is a mixture? Mixture, it's again a substance where 2 substances are mixed physically. Okay. I quoted a word as physically combined. So they are not chemically combined. Means there is no bond formation at all. Okay. So at home, just take 1 spoon of salt and 1 spoon of sugar on your hand. We'll say that as a mixture, because still you can see sugar granules, still you can see salt granules. Holding it for many days or just for few minutes, you cannot see those two will start combining. So these are known as mixtures. So they are physically, you have just made them to combine. They are not chemically combining. So these are known as mixture. So there is a box over there, like 4 boxes you can see. You have to identify which are elements, compound and mixture. In that X box, you can see capital X, you can see those green color ball sort of a structures. In case of Y, there's a green color stuff and there's a purple color stuff. Whereas in Z, you can also see 3 balls over there. Yeah, purple, white and pink. In W, you can see there's some green color box individually and there are 2 things which are combined, green with purple, and there's 3 things, blue with white and pink. So there's something like many things are there. So find out what it can be. Yes, when you take X, it's one particular thing what you see. It's, it gives us hint it's made up of one particular kind of an atom. So it's an element. Okay. Same atoms will be there to form an element. Coming to Y, there are 2 different kinds of atoms. Green one is a bigger one, whereas purple will be a smaller one. You can take an example of HCl, right? So H can be the purple one, Cl, chlorine can be green one. So this is a compound, okay? Z, you can have 3 things over here. So wherever you see, there's a 3 stuff which is combined in nature. And this is also a compound. So they are chemically combined. Coming to W, you can see this stuff. You can see these 3 things combined. You can see individual stuff which is present. So automatically it is mixture. What do you mean by atomic number? Atomic number, it's nothing but number of protons. I didn't say it's a number of electrons because electrons can come out of the atom to become ions. So always you think atomic number is nothing but number of protons. What do you mean by mass number? It's a summation of protons and neutrons. So protons and neutrons are present inside the nucleus, whereas electron is present outside the nucleus. So these are subatomic particles also, right? So where to write this mass number? It's always a superscript. Where to write the atomic number? It's always a subscript. And it is denoted by, mass number is denoted by A, atomic number is denoted by Z. So what is this capital X? It can be any element. It's a symbol. Here is an example for you. Cobalt, it's a symbol of an element. Mass number is 59 and atomic number is 27. So how will you find out the number of neutrons now? Right? Because neutron is present along with protons to form a mass number. How will I get only the number of neutrons? Simple formula is A minus Z. So if you do 59 minus 27, you'll end up with some number. Find out that number. That will be the number of neutrons. Next, what are isotopes? Isotopes are the atoms of the same element which have different number of neutrons and same number of protons and electrons. You can see all the 3. It's an isotope of hydrogen, protium, deuterium, tritium. Proton electrons are same, but there's no neutron in first one, protium. There's only 1 neutron in the second one. And in third one, when you see, there are 2 neutrons. So these are isotopes. What are isobars? The atoms which have same number of nucleons means The number of protons and neutrons, the mass number will be same. So, but their atomic number keeps on varying. You can see neutron number over there. Neutron number is also changing. You can see proton number is also changing. You can see over here argon, potassium and calcium. They have same mass number, but they have different atomic number. This is an assignment for you. There's 8 boxes from A to H. Just take your time and identify which can be element, which can be molecule, which is a compound. And find out if there is a mixture also. Yeah? Basic concepts what you are studying, start applying for this. What is that? Next, find the number of neutrons in the following. Above these three, you have to find the number of neutrons. Then, write the elements from 1 to 30 with their atomic numbers and symbols. So, write down all in your books, notebooks or on a sheet of paper. So, be ready with this. These are all the basic concepts which is required for you for the further classes. Thank you. So, we'll have definitely a good sessions hereafter. So, we'll start with the new concepts next class.